Well, hello, traders and investors. My name is Roger Scott, and I'm the senior strategist for Wealth Press. Today is Wednesday. It is the 17th of February. And no, I don't know where the year has gone. I feel like we're in a black hole. But let's talk about global economy. Let's talk about the indices right now. Let's talk about the news that's coming out on the table for the remainder of the week. And then let's talk about the top ETF and the top global ETF. This is going to be a very interesting segment. What do I always say? Let's get into it right now. All right, global shares were mostly lower Wednesday. Folks, we're sitting at new highs right now, or near all-time highs. The markets are stretched and they need to pull back. Vaccine rollout in Japan and recovery of exports as overseas economies rebound will prove key for the Japanese economy. That's going to be huge, huge, huge. Back to America, indexes closed mostly lower on Tuesday. Folks, we're really, really stretched out right now. As losses in healthcare stocks and technology companies kept gains in energy and other sectors of the market in check. Rising bond yield. I'll show you interest rates right now, but to give you an idea of what I'm talking about, let me just show you bond yields. This is the 10-year bond. And remember, there's an inverse relationship between interest rates and bonds. And this thing is just falling, falling, falling. So yields, interest yields are going higher. Bond prices going lower, interest rates going higher. So in light of that, let's talk about this. So yield on the 10-year treasury slipped back 1.28 from 1.29 late Tuesday, the highest level in a year. The lowest level in a year. You see that? Inverse. They're inverse. Just keep that in mind. Where were we here? Bank stocks make broad gains and high yield, very true, which allows them to change more lucrative interest rates on loans, which is why financial companies have been going higher. But utilities and real estate stocks, interest rates, home sales, remember, higher interest rates. Bond proxies can look less attractive when bond yields rise, were among the big decliners. So utilities and real estate. But I don't know, I'm not so sure. I mean, interest rates are still really, really low. I mean, like near historic lows. Optimism that Washington will come through on trillions of dollars of more aid for the economy and encouraging company earnings reports have helped stocks grind higher this month. But folks, I'm telling you right now, internally, things are not as pretty. Along with hopes that the COVID vaccine rollout will set the stage for stronger economic growth in the second half of the year. I'm sure hoping for that. Markets are, in fact, looking forward right now. That's the beauty of this whole thing. But right now, if we see, let's just say this, we're extremely fragile right now. If we find out that the vaccines don't protect us against these new super duper COVID strains, we're screwed. If we find out that the vaccine rollout isn't in time, we're screwed. Basically, anything can really undo or unglue the progress we have made. U.S. Congress can now make progress towards passing President Joe Biden's $1.9 trillion stimulus plan. The package would include one-time payment to Americans plus additional assistance to industry, states, and jurisdictions impacted by the pandemic. Now, when he says additional to industries, electric vehicle, solar-powered industries, healthcare industries, that's where Biden wants to put his cash. Now, let's talk about global markets. We're right now, markets going to open up in about an hour and 15 minutes. We're mildly lower, nothing crazy. If you look at the numbers that are coming out, the Fed data that's coming out, today we have retail sales coming out in about 13 minutes. That's the big report for today, and industrial production. PPI too, but I don't think producers' price index is going to be a shock. I mean, we're in an inflationary environment right now. But industrial production, retail sales are going to give us some really good clues. We have the FOMC report at 2, where the Fed, let me make a prediction, they're going to say we're not going to raise rates for the foreseeable future. That's not really helping the long bond, right? The 20-year plus, right? Because rates are going higher, even though short-term rates are staying stagnant. The other big reports for the week is going to be the housing starts, the jobless claims, and the manufacturing index. Existing home sales, not so much. PMI composite flash, not so much. So today, the retail sales, industrial production are going to be the big ones. And then tomorrow, we're going to have the housing starts, Fed manufacturing, and jobless claims. Jobless claims is going to be the big one. And you guys know exactly what I'm expecting. The number went all the way to 965,000 before dropping to 793,000. The four-week moving average is 823,000. Not a lot of progress over the last year. consensus 768. I'd love to see this consensus number. I don't know if we're going to beat it, but I would love to see the consensus number. I want to see this moving average going down, down, down. If it can't go down, we are going to be screwed. Screwed, screwed, screwed. Now, in terms of global economy, in the world right now, or actually in the US right now, this is the number one ETF. I don't think it's a big surprise to anyone. Global Clean Energy, ICLN, is the ticker symbol. It's pulling back to the 50-day moving average. I like this ETF right now. I like it quite a bit. ICLN is the ticker symbol. In terms of global ETFs, now this is in US, this is a US stock exchange ETF. This is where we look at all ETFs, local ETFs. ICLN is the leading one. In terms of global ETFs, it still remains South Korea. South Korea is the one. And as you can see here, it's doing fairly well, ticker symbol EWY. Now, I wanna take a look at the 10 major indexes, 10 major sectors, excuse me. You could see here financials breaking out, it's moving higher, but again, if you look longer term, you will see that it's only finally now breaking above the February high, which means it's time to get bullish on financials. Finally, 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 that day is here, we are breaking out, and I am now bullish on financials. Now, what about the energy sector? Not so fast. Look at where we're at on energy. We're not even close to breaking that level. That level needs to be is right here. It's near the 55 level. We're at 46 right now. So I'm not bullish on energy, but I am changing my focus on financials. We are officially in a breakout mode. Now, as far as the overall market, tech looks a little stretched out right here. Industrial, I still like, although I think we're gonna come down a little bit, come off. Consumer discretionary is starting to lag a little bit. And real estate is still doing pretty well. But the sector that I'm really happy about today is the financial sector. Now, let's look at the S&P 500 and find some financial stocks. You see how I'm doing all of this? And I'm doing this all about an hour and 10 minutes before the market opens. So financial stocks. I'm having trouble speaking early in the morning. Discovery. I've been talking about Discovery for a while now. Discovery credit card, they don't have any commercial exposure. There's no businesses. It's all people. It's all consumers. So that's a great one. Discovery, 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 and SIVB Financial. I've been talking about these two stocks. There's also Invesco, but Discovery, let's see here, SIVB and Invesco. Those three are solid in the S&P 500. And I hope that gives you a good idea of where we stand. I think that the lower interest rates, the lower bond market's gonna go, higher rates are gonna go, it's gonna prop up more financial companies. But the fact that financials, the fact that, let me just show you this here. Let me go back to the major indices. XLF, here we go. The fact that we are finally breaking above this level is huge, huge, huge in the financial sector. Very, very big. Now, I've got something for you. I don't want you to go anywhere. Pay attention and pay attention close. From 1993 to 2021, that's from 1993 to 2021, you could have lost 10% of your money buying and holding the S&P during the day. That's right. If you'd bought at the close and sold again right at the open, you'd have seen 812% increase on your investment. So if from 93 to 2021, if you were to just buy and hold stocks, you'd lose 10%. But if you close and then buy again at the open, you make 812% on your investment. Big difference, right? Where did all the gains come from? Overnight moves. Overnight moves. And one former $700 million hedge fund trader just revealed how he's exploiting these overnight moves on a handful of stocks every single day. Click on the link below to see how he's doing this and see the stocks he's trading next. You don't want to miss out on this, folks. Former $700 million hedge fund manager, he's revealing how he's exploiting these overnight moves. You've got to check this out. And you'll even find out the stocks, or the handful of stocks that he's looking to trade this on. follow the link below. You've got to check this out. And make sure to like this video and subscribe to this channel. And if you're watching on YouTube, stay ahead of the market by being the first to be notified when we release new videos. Most importantly, have a great, great day. Bye, folks. Stay out of trouble.